Namaskar. In this video, I'm going to explain the phonetic basis of the Hindi writing system, the Devanagari script. The Devanagari writing system is inherited from Sanskritic linguistic traditions. The vowels and consonants are placed in a very specific order based on their phonetic features. In this video, I'm going to describe the phonetic basis of the Devanagari writing system. The very first thing we see here that the vowels are separated from the consonants. The vowels are a separate set of letters in the beginning of the alphabets. As we learned, they are a, a, e, e, u, u, ri, a, I, o, and au. Then come consonants. The consonants are also classified into a few sets. The first set has 5 rows and 5 columns. Here you can see the first 5 rows and 4 columns are stop consonants. The fifth column is nasals. The second set has semivowels. The third set is sibilant. And the final one letter set is the aspirate H. Let's take the first set of consonants. Let's first start the first 5 rows and only first 4 columns. These all are stop consonants. They are also called plosive consonants. So a stop consonant is a sound made by completely blocking the flow of air and then releasing it. For example, P, T, Ch, B. So if I ask you to stretch the sound of a stop consonant, you cannot do it. Let's try. P, T. What you are doing here is stretching the A sound, not the consonant sound. In contrast, if I ask you to stretch the S sound, you can easily do it. S or na, na or ma, ma. But with stop consonants, you cannot do it. And the last column is the nasal sound. That means you produce these sounds with the flow of air through your nose. For example, nya, nya, na, na, and ma. And let's now take the rows first. The first row is the velar sounds. K, kh, g, gh, ng. They are made in the velum or the soft palate in the vocal apparatus at the back of your throat. You can see where they are produced in this diagram. K, kh, g, gh, ng. The second row is the palatal sounds. Ch, ch, j, j, ny. The front part of the tongue touches the hard palate up. Ch, ch, j, j, ny. Here you can see where they are produced in the diagram. The third row is the retroflex sounds. T, th, d, dh, ṇ. The tip of the tongue touches the hard palate. The tongue curls back and its tip touches the hard palate. T, th, d, dh, ṇ. Here in the diagram, you can see where these sounds are produced. The fourth row is the dental sounds. T, th, d, dh, ṇ. The tongue touches the upper teeth. T, th, d, dh, ṇ. Here in the diagram, you can see where these sounds are produced. And the final row is the bilabial sounds. P, p, b, bh, m. While articulating these sounds, the two lips, upper and lower lip, meet. P, p, b, bh, m. Here you can see in the diagram how these sounds are produced. So this was the phonetic explanation of the row. Let's now take the columns. The columns are organized based on voicing, aspiration, and nasal. The first column is voiceless, unaspirated consonants. K, ch, t, t, and p. The second column is voiceless, aspirated consonants. K, ch, t, th, p. They are aspirated counterpart of the first column consonant. That means when they are pronounced, there is a puff of air going out. K, ch, th, th, Huh. The third column is the voiced unaspirated consonants. They are voiced counterpart of the first column consonants. G, J, D, D, and B. That means while pronouncing these sounds, you feel a little vibration in your throat. You can place two fingers on your throat and feel the vibration. G, J, D, D, and B. The fourth column is voiced aspirated consonants. G, J, D, D, and B. They are both voiced and aspirated. That means there is a puff of air coming out as well as vibration when you pronounce them. G, J, D, D, and B. And the final column is the nasal sounds. Y, N, 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 and M. Nasal sounds means that you produce these sounds with the flow of air through your nose. Y, N, 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 and M. So you can see that every consonant has its specific place in the table based on the place of articulation, voicing, and aspiration. The next set of consonants are semivowels. Y, R, L, V. The next three consonants are sibilants. Sh, sh, s. The sibilant sounds are made by directing the stream of air while producing the hissing sound. They are sh, sh, s. And the final consonant is the aspirate h sound, h. So you can see that how the sound system is scientifically organized in Devanagari. If you are studying linguistics, this organized sound system can help you to understand phonetics. This completes the Devanagari alphabet system as we traditionally have in Sanskrit. However, in Hindi, there are some more consonants that have come from other languages. In our next video, we will take those consonants. They are called dotted consonants. Namaskar.